Hello, humans, I'm back. And this time I have something different from the three videos I uploaded previously. The reason for the lack of recent videos is that my creator was unsatisfied with the video format and has been dedicating most of his free time to enhancing both visual quality and writing. One significant change involves replacing my 3D model with a 2D one to achieve smoother cloth physics without causing a GPU meltdown. I think I'm cute in 3D as well. Hopefully, I'll finally get my beautiful, cabbly hair, so you, dear viewer, will no longer have to be blinded by my shiny head. For my transition to 2D, I'll be using a nice piece of software named Inochi2D, which is free of charge and open source, just the way my maker likes it. I want to express my gratitude to Luna and the team for providing such an incredible tool. What I'm going to present next is not a tutorial per se, but more of an overview of what my maker achieved on the first day of using Inochi without any prior experience in 2D animation and rigging. This video was made in response to requests from a few Discord users who were curious about how the head rotation at 90 degrees was achieved. Keep in mind that the footage you see here has undergone many reshoots, because carbon-based beings are flawed. But hey, aren't imperfections what make humans so special? Without further ado, let's begin. After rendering my 3D body in front view, it was rotated at 22.5, 45, 67.5, and 90 degrees, and then the images were imported into Photoshop as separate layers. Using the pen tool set on shape, my head outline was traced in front view. The shape was duplicated under it and filled with my skin color. A similar process was applied to create the ears, while my nose started as a simple ellipse. Other features like my eyes and eyebrows were taken from my original body.
Wait, where's my mouth?
In Inochi, a new document was created, and the PSD file was imported. A node hierarchy was established for each individual body part. For this video, only the face shape and the nose will be deformed. Starting with the face outline, a mesh will be created for it. In this case, automesh is to be avoided, as we need only the exterior and interior of the outline to be traced and triangulated manually. Triangulation must be done manually, otherwise the entire mesh will be screwed, and the undo button won't save you in this version. Before proceeding further, back in Photoshop, the outline was turned into a smart object. Inside the smart object, another layer was created above and filled with the outline color. A thick stroke of the same color was added to the smart object. On the face color layer, a thin outline was created to prevent it from bleeding under the original outline. Back in Inochi, the merge option was selected under File, and the modified PSD file was selected so the images will update. This way, a much crisper outline was created that will deform more smoothly. Once the mesh for the outline was completed, it was copied to the face color and then edited by adding extra vertices to fill the mesh in. The auto triangulate function can be used for this step. For the head movement parameter, constraints were set between -2 and 2 on both the X and Y axes. Additional axis points were added to the X axis in increments of 0.25 from -2 to 2. I should note that at this moment, most of the 0.25 and 0.75 points are missing from the footage, but my maker realized later that those are necessary for a smoother transition. Starting at the -0.5 point, the reference image rotated at 22.5 degrees was made visible. Based on the reference image, both the outline and color meshes were deformed accordingly. If you plan to follow along, remember to have both meshes selected by holding the Shift key and then clicking on both of them. For the 45, 67.5, and 90 degree angles respectively, the mesh was deformed at the -1, -1.5, and -2 points. The in-between points are for smoothing the transition and ensuring that weird deformations won't occur. The points were copied and pasted to their right side counterparts, then set from the mirror diagonally. As the nose shape was moved around, it required an additional step by selecting the two transforms X and Y under binding and mirroring horizontally. That's it. I hope you learned something new from my maker's first day of using Inochi2D. If you're curious to try the software, the download link is in the description. I must thank the developers again for their dedication and patience in providing technical support on Discord. As for my next video, I can't guarantee a release date. A standard intro and an outro for my videos are in progress. Yes, I now own a Marischal tank destroyer, Future videos that have any connection to World War II history will come with printable assets for creating board games, allowing you to enjoy them with your friends. So stay tuned. Until next time, have a great day. See you!